हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड शॉक थेरेपी एंड टुडे वी विल स्टडी कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ शॉक थेरेपी। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, शॉक थेरेपी कुड नॉट फुलफिल द प्रोमिसेस एंड एम्बिशंस ऑफ द पीपल, दोज वर ऑफ यूटोपिया means an ideal condition for everything, for consumption, for production, for the life. So shock therapy could not fulfill the promises of the people. Generally it brought a ruin to the economies. Generally shock therapy ruined the economies and brought disaster to the people of the USSR region. As economies were destroyed, so the people have to pay high cost for everything. In Russia, the large state controlled industrial complex almost collapsed. In Russia, the large industries were collapsed, and almost 90% of those industries were kept for sale, and they were obtained by private players, private individuals and private companies, and there was no proper instructions given by the government. And the economy was in the hands of the private individuals. There was no proper rule for the sale, no proper guidelines for the sale, and it appeared that the situation was even worse than before. No doubt the public was given some vouchers to take part in the sale, but due to the need of money, people sold those vouchers and fulfilled their daily needs, ambitions. In this way, few rich people, few rich individuals, private players controlled over the vast economy. The value of ruble, the Russian currency, declined. At that same time, the value of Russian currency, that is ruble, was declined, and the GDP of Russia, gross domestic product of Russia, which also declined, and it was even less than in comparison 1989. As the old structure of government was completely destroyed, so there was emerging private players and they controlled the economy. The old system of social welfare was systematically destroyed. The withdrawals of government subsidies pushed large sections of the people into poverty. The social welfare system, which was earlier made by the USSR government, gradually destroyed schemes which were playing great role for social welfare. They also destroyed one by one, and government withdrawal, so subsidiaries slowly and slowly. That's why people of that area turned poorer and poorer. The middle class was almost out of the society, and they were cornered. And the academic and intellectual manpower disintegrated or migrated. Due to these problems, high inflation, devaluation of ruble, and economy being controlled by private players, the intellectual property and manpower, means intelligent people like scientists, engineers, and other, they migrated to other countries, and the economies were controlled by some mafias who were dealing in private acquisition or privatization. Post-Soviet states, especially Russia, were divided. In that time, Russia was divided between rich and poor regions. Unlike previous society division, now Russia was divided into two sections. Those sections were the rich and poor. The construction of democratic institutions was not given the same attention and priority as the demands of economic infrastructure. Construction of democratic institutions which can make proper laws and guidelines for the betterment of society was not enough, and it was not given enough attention to. That's why the condition deteriorated. The condition of all these countries were constitution of all these countries were drafted in a hurry, and most including Russia. At that time, the constitutions of all those countries were drafted in haste, and that's why the presidents or the heads of states of some countries turned very powerful, and they made opposition very big, and sometimes they declared themselves as the leader for some time, and they extended their time period again and again. In Central Asia, the presidents had great power, and several of them became very authoritarian. In Central Asia, like Russia, Uzbekistan, the president of these countries became very powerful, and they became quite authoritarian. For example, the presidents of Turkmenistan and Uzbekistan appointed themselves to power for first 10 years and then extended it for another 10 years. For example, presidents of Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, they appointed themselves as the head of the nation for 10 years firstly, and after 10 years being completed, they extended their time, their tenure, up to next 10 years. So they became quite authoritarian and made opposition very weak. They allowed no dissent or opposition. A judicial culture and independence of the judiciary was yet to be established in most of these countries. The judicial system was totally destroyed, as the head was taking decisions for the nation himself. And the presidents of these countries turned authoritarian, they made opposition weak, and they made the importance of judiciary negligible. Most of these countries, especially Russia, started reviving in 2000, 10 years after their independence. Most of these countries, especially Russia, started reviving itself, started reviving its society, reviving its system in 2000 after 10 years of its independence. The reason for revival was most of their economies was the export of natural resources like oil, natural gas, and minerals. So the reason for revival, economy, rules, politics, was that the main items of export from where Russia was getting funds, money, were oil, natural gas, and minerals. Azerbaijan, Kazakhstan, Russia, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan were major oil and gas producers. Countries of Central Asia like Azerbaijan, Kazakhstan, Russia, Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, they were major producer of gas products in the world. So they revived their economies. Other countries have gained because of the oil pipelines that cross their territories, for which they yet get rent. Other countries were also benefited. As for the export of oil and gas, these countries made some pipelines, and those pipelines were passed through some other countries. And when the pipeline was passed from other countries, territories, they got rent for that pipeline. So other countries were also benefited in this way. Some amount of manufacturing had restarted, and some units for manufacturing, some industry for manufacturing had started in that area by 2000. So today we studied about the consequences of shock therapy. The economies were destroyed, people suffered a lot, and the economy was grabbed by private individuals, private players, and some mafias. And in 2000, after 10 years of independence, Russia revived its economy. So dear students, we studied the consequences of shock therapy, and in next class we will discuss tensions and conflicts. So dear students, watch this video from beginning till end, and if you have any doubt, you can clear your doubt through comment box. And thank you for watching this video.